or apple pie, cinnamon whipped cream, and vanilla ice cream. It sounds good, doesn't it? But it's just like our relationship with God. If you ever taste and see for yourself, you realize that there's nobody like the Lord in your life. Better than chocolate chip cookies. Better than brownies. Better than that dessert that's been sitting in the refrigerator waiting for you all day. If you taste and see that the Lord is good, then it will change your life. As we stand all over the sanctuary. Someone may say, well, Pastor, I hear what you're saying, and I want to taste and see that the Lord is good, but I want to share this with you. According to Romans 10 and 9, the Word of God teaches us that if we shall confess with our mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in our heart that God hath raised Jesus from the dead, thou shalt be saved. What a tragedy it would be to hear the Word of God preached and hear the Lord knocking on your heart and you not come and taste and see that the Lord is good.
All right.
If you're here today and you feel the Lord tugging on your heart, you say, you know what? I want to make sure that if the clouds should crack today and the Lord come back, that I would be able to go with him in eternity. If you're here today and you have not accepted the Lord as your Savior, we invite you to come. As the choir sings a hymn of invitation, we invite you to come. If you're here, you say, you know what? I want to get it right. I want to taste and see that the Lord is good. I want to declare my eternal home and glory. We invite you to come. As the choir sings, don't look to the left. Don't look to the right. But today is your day.
Seems like a river
for salvation.
Like a vision.
The second call is a call for rededication. If you're here today, so you know what? I want to give my very best to the Lord, and I want the Lord to be first in my heart. We invite you to come today. We invite you to come today. And at this time, the doors of the church are open. If you desire prayer, we want to pray the word of faith with you, because we know that the Lord is able to heal. We know that he's able to deliver. We know that he's a long-time God. Won't you come?
Church, amen.
Amen.
Church, amen.
Yeah. We come again, Lord, to simply say thank you for your word.
Thank you, Lord.
A word that encourages us and reminds us that who we are truly. Thank you. We thank you for the preacher who came before us today, oh God, and how you used him. How he was able to encourage us through your word and through your Holy Spirit. That you are able to carry us through the struggles of life. So here we are again, Lord, realizing that you are the source of all our beings. And Lord, we are so glad that you are omniscient, omnipotent God. Who knows everything. Who sees everything. Who has all power in your hand. We are so glad that you are God that can be in all places at all times. We are so glad, oh God, that there's no mountain too high. There's no valley too low. That you can't turn us through. So here we are. Lord, you hear every name that was called out. So we ask you in the name of Jesus, oh God, to touch, deliver, and heal according to your will and purpose, oh God, in your children's life. Help us to be mindful, oh God, that you are truly a God who's able to do all things through us, oh God, for those of us who love you and trust you. So, Lord, we ask in Jesus.
us when we go.
Yeah.
Tell somebody else just how good our God is. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We're going to thank the choir.
Amen. Amen.
Songs and praise. Thank you, ushers, to each of you who came today. While I'm saying that, I do want to say that, talking about the choir, the Reverend Elder Evers said today was his mother's birthday. She was 106 years old. I think it's worth saying that she was the first youth choir pianist that we had in this Alabama church. She wouldn't let nobody bother with us either. Nobody trying to talk to her, she wouldn't let nobody. She was taking us, man. But she was the first youth choir. He had director that I can remember. Yeah. Here at Allen Chapel.
Yeah, when she was your
so she
grew me.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I've been in youth choir, she grew the ball.
So you see, she shaped a bit of our lives. And we're still here today. Yeah. Even though she gone on to heaven, but her legacy is still going on. Right here in the Allen Chapel. Because
yeah.
I know that's when I started dancing on the piano.
Oh, yeah.
and I did like the prophet's son. I danced on the piano in the church and I left and straight away a little bit and started dancing on the pool table at one home. But thank be to God.
Let the church say amen.
May he keep you. May he lift his countenance up upon you and give you joy, peace, and happiness, now, henceforth, and evermore. And all of God's children sang together.
Let the church